Morning, welcome to weekly vlog number 17. Today I am going to London to go and see Pippa and I'm very excited and I think we're filming some outfit videos today. So I have everything prepared. I've got my little backpacks, it's way easier to carry around. My heels are going in the car, my tripod, and I'm taking my Presley flap fossil bag because I love it and it's very
autumnal and that is the theme I'm going for today. I first need to go to Halfords because I need to get like a little in-car phone holder thing. So I'm using my car, I'm driving basically. Mainly because A, it's Sunday and trains are a nightmare on Sunday. B, I'm just happier driving than getting the train on my own with all of my camera stuff. And C, I'm coming home, like obviously it's going to be in the dark and it's the night before Halloween. And one of my biggest fears is like big fancy dress and masks, and makes me feel weird just talking about it. And not being able to see someone's face, and obviously with it being the night before Halloween and the last weekend day before Halloween, I feel like there is going to be a lot of that on the trains and I'm not sure I would cope. So I'm taking the sensible choice, probably the slightly more expensive, but I am much happier doing it and I'm driving there. But it actually takes the exact same amount of time, if not, probably like, it's probably slightly quicker. But instead of meeting Pippa in London, I'm meeting her at her house. So yeah, that is what's happening. I need to leave, it is 10 past 11 and I need to be left by 12 because I'm like at the latest, because I said I would get to her for 1. It takes about 1 hour and 6 minutes, so my sat nav says. So yes, I need to go to Halfords and then get some petrol. I need to top up for my petrol. So yeah, let's go. I just can't get the light settings right on this camera, so I'm really sorry if sometimes I'm really light, like bright, and sometimes I'm really dark, but I have made it to Halfords, so I need to go and find a phone holder. It's very busy. I thought it'd be like dead here because it's a Sunday, but nope, I was wrong. I've bought it, but I've already like pulled a bit off of it, so I need to now try and fix it. God damn it. Me and things like this just are not friends. We're not friends, people. I twisted it the wrong way. Because I was doing it backwards, so I thought left was right and right was left, so I actually undid it instead of doing it up. Because I'm really clever like that, let's be honest. That's just what I'm like. Right, what way around am I? This way. Right, look, yay, I got a purple one. It was on offer, it should be like £25, but it was a tenner instead, so that was good. And they had loads of different colours and I was like, I want a girly colour, so I went for purple. Right, let's see if my phone fits in it, shall we? Let's just plop you there while I give it a go. I don't see why it won't fit. It's really similar to like the one that I had last time. Yay! Oh, that's awkward. Someone's parked next to me. I talk to myself. Right, they've got out of the car. That was really awkward. I need to go get petrol and then leave. I also need to work out how to change the time on my car clock. Let's try and work that one out, shall we? Right, menu. Computer? Menu. No. There must be...
Ordinary happens.
No, that's the radio.
Right, November.
Shh, radio, shh. Right. Surely it's got to be in the computer a bit. No. Average speed, range. No, I want to change the time. Tell me how to change the time. Oh, I'm gonna have to look in the manual. I don't have time for this. We have to be an hour ahead for now because I need to go get petrol, so. But that works, look at that, yay! Guys, you have no idea how much I wish someone just filmed me do that parallel park. That was literally the best parallel park I have ever done. I'm so proud of myself. Is that really sad? Oh my God, it was so good. I'm like perfectly in, the spot was the perfect size, and I have made it, and it is. What is the time? Like 2 minutes to 1, and I'm so excited. These houses are so cute. She's number 19, so I need to find number 19. And then I've found my little cherub. I've found her. I made it to London, everybody. I'm safe.
We have come to South Kensington to come and do a little bit of filming because it is absolutely beautiful around here, as you can see. We've just been like walking around trying to find the perfect spot, and I think we found it.
Yay!
Here she is.
She's come to see me.
Yeah. It's so pretty around here, it's unreal. So I'm really excited to film here. And then we're gonna find a roast dinner.
Yep, get in my belly.
Yeah, we really want a roast dinner.
It's so ridiculous around here, like it's crazy. Like, and we've got private gardens behind us, which we can't go into unfortunately, but it's so autumnal and pretty around here.
It's beautiful.
I love it.
And then we need to get a cup of tea.
Yeah, I'm feeling it.
Tea too.
Yeah. We have finished filming now and taking vlog pictures. I literally want to live here, it's beautiful. Like, every single house is like Instagram picture. We've now come to Byronbury because it's very cold, and actually neither of us have eaten since breakfast, so we're pretty hungry. So we are going to order some food. We're both getting milkshakes and we're getting two different ones because we both want to try each one. We thought that's the best way to do it. Here's my little view.
Oh, that was just your boobs.
Sorry, I'm just sending memes to people about how fat I am.
Oh, about to have a milkshake as well. She is not fat. Evening, it's time to go home. I've just left Pippa's. It's 7:40, so I should be home by like 8:50, which is a good time. Hopefully there's not gonna be much traffic. It says it's gonna take me 1 hour and 7 minutes, so I think we're okay. I've had to wear my glasses though, because it's gonna be dark. My eyes have been really sensitive, like I said in last week's vlog, like with lights and stuff. They started to really hurt, so I've put my glasses on. I'm ready for these bright lights. I'm hoping it's gonna be quite a smooth journey, but we will see. I've had such a good day. I love Pippa to absolute pieces. She's such a nice girl. We get on so, so well. I just wish I could see her more, but she's really busy, I'm really busy. She now lives in London, so yeah. But I'm gonna see her really soon, hopefully. But now I'm gonna drive home and have a cup of tea when I get home. I feel like I probably should have peed before I left. And I have made it to Daniel's house. I've literally had the best day today, but I am so pooped. I think I'm just gonna get into my pajamas. I'm really thirsty, so I'm kind of hoping he's got some orange juice in the fridge, because I really fancy like a big glass of orange juice. And I'm just gonna put a film on, I think, and just sit and relax for a bit. I love that feeling though, when you've had like a really productive day and you've been out all day and you know it's been a really good day, and but when you get home, you don't have to move anymore. It's just the best feeling. I hope you all had a really nice Sunday too, and I'll see you in the morning. Good night. Now 11:30, and I said I was gonna get in my pajamas at like 10:15. I've just been sat here watching YouTube videos. I am now going to go get in my pajamas and put my phone down. Good afternoon. It is 3:15 on a Monday. My hair looks kind of weird. We've just been to Tesco's to get some food. I'm gonna put that away and I'm gonna watch some YouTube while I do it. Here's my shopping, lovely. I also went to Pets at Home because I had to get some bedding, and every time I get the hamster out, she like snuggles into my dressing gown or my mum's dressing gown. So I decided to pick up, you can get some fleecy bedding for hamsters. So I decided to get some of that instead of, normally I get like the shards of like, I don't know what it is, it's like papery type stuff. Normally I get that, but I decided to get like the actual like fluffy stuff to see if she prefers that, because she likes my dressing gown. So she's possibly gonna like that. And I also picked up some new food for her to see if she'll eat that too. What do I watch while I put stuff away? Let's watch some Sacconi Judy's because I haven't watched those for ages. Hello, Eduardo. Hello, Amelia. I need to catch up on a video, so I can't watch that one yet. Hold up, hold up. What haven't I watched? Flying Alone. Okay. Where do I put you? In the bread bin? I pressed off. Oh, hold up. They're sitting on the herbs. Right, let's put this away and make tuna sandwiches. Look, I'm so excited to try these. I've seen these before. Yum, and I think Daniel's on like a chocolate hype at the moment because he also just like picked this up and chucked it in. But I am not complaining about chocolate. Oh no. So they are our nibbles tonight. I'm going to try and persuade Daniel. Try and persuade him to watch some scary films because obviously it's Halloween and we're not going out anywhere. So I'm going to try and get him. Look at my hair. Don't quite know what's going on there. I'm going to try and persuade him to watch some scary films. Yes, I am. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Today's pretty much been a write-off. Oh.
It pretty much sums the day up.
Yeah.
And illuminate.
Oh, seatbelt. I may have drunk. Oh my goodness, this is literally.
Do you want maybe start that again?
Yeah.
Okay.
I may have drunk slightly, well, not too much, but why are you not focusing on me?
You're not meant to do it, apparently.
Come on. As I was trying to say earlier, I drank way too much last night and this morning was kind of a write-off. I got up at 11, which is quite good since I went to bed at 2, and then proceeded to then go back to bed until 2:30 because I had to come home because I had to take the hamster to the vets again. She's fine, she's had her teeth chipped again and she's going back in 6 weeks to have them cut again. She's constantly going to be at the dentist. But yeah, I thought Chris had decided he was going to Tesco's and I was like, I probably kind of need to leave the house. So I came too. So here we are.
In Tesco's.
In Tesco's. In Tesco's. And I just got really excited because we walked up to the clothes bit and they were playing Polar Express. And that's my favourite Christmas film ever in the whole world. So yeah, got a little bit too excited about that one, didn't I?
I think we may have just walked past everything we wanted to actually stop for.
Ah.
Turn around.
Turning. Mum's given him a shopping list and we're trying to find everything on the shopping list.
Where we can sauces.
Sauces. We need to just read signs.
Yeah.
And then we'll know where things are. Yeah, we should probably continue shopping now and pay attention to what we're buying.
Also yum. Are they about to fit in there as well?
Probably not.
Thank you.
Oh. I can probably fit that.
We must have the same taste, you'll have to come round for dinner.
Or you can come
on. Shopping is dirt. You're too tall. I can't have
you
in the camera with me.
There it is done. It's on my knees if I continue to walk like that.
Yeah. We took a snapshot earlier and he had to bend down and lean against the cupboard because otherwise I was like, just like the bobble hat, no head. Are we going to Halfords now?
We need to do a smell test on the car smelly. If it still smells, then we're fine. If it doesn't smell anymore, then we need to go Halfords.
Okay.
And try and resist the urge to stop at Burger King on the way past.
Oh, that would be such a good hangover dinner.
The urge will be resisted, sorry.
Oh, damn it. This is nice lighting. Do you know, sometimes I just come out with Chris so I can go in his car. And it's a really nice car. He's just taking the trolley. But yeah, sometimes if he's like, oh, I'm going to Tesco's, I'm going here, I'm like, yeah, I'll come. Just so I can sit in the car. I like his car, if you haven't guessed. Where's he gone? There he is.
It is me.
It is me. To Halfords we... Oh, wait, let's smell it.
Smell test. Do you still... Do you come off the gear stick? That's the most important
I've
thing.
I've never seen anything like that. That still smells.
Okay.
Home Halfords. We go.
Halfords triple rated.
A proper hangover dinner. Seems as I wasn't allowed a Burger King. Potato waffles, chicken dippers and baked beans. I am so hungry. Good afternoon, my loves. I'm about to leave to go to the nurse because today I have my contraception checkup and my smear test. And I'm so nervous. I've actually been putting it off for like 3 months. You get a letter basically like a month before you turn 25 inviting you to come and have your smear test, and you obviously have to make your appointment. And I put it off. And then I got another letter from my actual doctor being like, we see you haven't made your appointment yet. We would like you to make one. And I needed to make an appointment with the nurse anyway because I needed to renew my pill. So I had the whole conversation with making the appointment for my pill and was like, I should probably book my smear test at the same time. So she was really nice and it is pretty much at the same time. You've got hair there. So I've got my pill checkup at 3:50 and then my smear at 4, so they should be one after each other. But I'm really nervous. I hate this sort of thing. Like, I've had tests and things done before. This is TMI, isn't it? But I don't know, there's just something about the smear test that just kind of scares me. I think it's because it's actually looking for something like really serious, and I shouldn't have put it off at all. And I know some people put it off way longer than I have. Like, I turned 25 obviously in August and it's now November, and I know some people that have put it off for years, so I'm quite proud of myself for doing it quickly. But I'm so nervous, I feel really anxious. I will obviously let you know how it goes. Not in great detail, but I'll let you know how, if I survive. But yeah, I'm really nervous. I don't mean, I'm just feeling really anxious about it, I think. It just makes me feel really vulnerable. I'm sure other women feel the same way. I just feel really vulnerable and... I don't know. I'm just really scared, guys. Really scared. I'm sure most girls feel like this when they have their first smear test, or even if like you're a woman and you've had loads, do you still get just as nervous each time? Right, what is the time? Like yakking away, I'm like, wait, where's the time? Okay, it's nearly 5:30. I need to leave at like 22 because my doctor's is only like round the corner for me. So it doesn't take me very long to get there, but yeah. I feel like I've kind of run my whole day around this as well, and it's like, I'm probably gonna be out of the house for like 45 minutes, if that, and I've run my whole day around it because I'm just like, I don't wanna start doing anything. I need to film a video and I should have done that this morning and I didn't. I wallowed in bed for a little bit longer than I should have and had a shower and everything. So I need to film that when I get home. But I feel like once I'm home, I'll be fine, but this morning I just couldn't focus on anything because I'm just really nervous. Yeah, I should probably go and stop yakking. Wish me luck. It's done. I didn't enjoy that one bit. Not that I was expecting to enjoy it, but it was worse than I thought it was going to be. But only because it turns out I'm a difficult customer. Yeah, I'm not going to go into detail, but it took longer than expected and it wasn't pleasant and I feel very uncomfortable right now, and focus on me. That really didn't help, did it? Yeah, so I don't really know what to say. I just feel really uncomfortable now and I want to go home. Also, I got there and I swear down my appointment was supposed to be at 10 to 4. And I like clocked in. You have to like check in at my doctor's to say that you're here and everything. And it said my appointment was at 4:40 and I was like, brilliant, but I couldn't be bothered to drive all the way home then come back again, because by the time I'd got home, it's obviously going to be like I'd be home 20 minutes and I'd leave, and what would I do? I'd just sit there on my phone, do nothing. So I just did that in the doctor's surgery instead. I did get seen earlier than my appointment, but still, that was kind of annoying. It's like, you could have told me that you changed my appointment, because I'm 100% sure my appointment was at 10 to 4, because I text my mum as soon as I'd hung up the phone and said I've got an appointment at 3:50 and 4. So I know I wasn't wrong. This person's gonna look really weird because I'm filming myself. I really don't care right now. So yeah, but it's done for the next 3 years and I have to go back. I'm already dreading it, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not like, some people are like, yeah, it's fine. Don't get me wrong, like, it's not the worst thing I've ever experienced in my whole life, but it was very unpleasant for me. Very unpleasant. And I'm sure for some people it's fine, but because of an issue that I have, it was worse than I thought it was going to be, and it took a little bit longer. But I think I deserve cake now, so I think I'm going to go to Asda and buy myself a chocolate cake and eat it all myself, and I don't care. So that's what I'm going to do right now. And my battery's now started flashing at me, so I need to go and charge my battery.
I've been home a little bit now and I had a little cry when I got in. I feel pathetic, but it was just horrible. And I was gonna film, like I said earlier, I was gonna film a video, but I think I'm just gonna film it in the morning now because I'm just not up to filming a video. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna organize my room a little bit. It's a bit of a mess and it needs a bit of a tidy, and that always makes me feel better. So I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna put something on Netflix and I'm gonna sort my room out and tidy my drawers, because look at this drawer. Yeah, that really needs tidying, let's be honest. So I'm gonna do that. And then I'm gonna have a bath, I think, tonight to clean. Oh. Cooper. Yeah, I'm just waiting for dinner. My makeup is all smudged. And then I'll eat dinner, tidy my room, watch some Netflix and have a bath and go to bed. And I've persuaded Mum to go to Primark tomorrow because I really want to go to Primark and start to get like some fairy lights and things to kind of Christmasify my room. So I'm like, it's November now, I'm allowed to start the process, right? And it will make me feel better. So that's what I'm going to do. Good morning, happy Thursday. Sorry about this, but I just wanted to say, I washed my hair yesterday. And you know, I bought a new shampoo and conditioner, the new Aveda one. I'm really impressed with it so far. Like, normally my second day hair is awful, but this still feels freshly washed. It like looks a bit flat because I haven't brushed it yet, but it feels amazing. I'm very impressed so far by this shampoo and conditioner. I've only used it twice, so it may be one off, because last time I shoved my hair up the next day, so I didn't really even get a chance to tell if what it looked like. But this morning I've woken up and I'm so impressed. Like, to be fair, it still looks a bit flat, but it looks so much better than it normally does on my second day. Like, it doesn't look greasy, it doesn't feel greasy, it still feels nice and soft and light, and I'm so impressed. I just thought I would let you know that. When did I buy my shampoo and conditioner? Did I show you this week? I'll show you which one it is, in case you didn't watch last week's vlog. I think it was last week's vlog that I told you all about it. Is this one. Hold up, look at this. It is this one. So the Aveda Pure Abundance with the clay conditioner. I love it. I'm very impressed with that shampoo and conditioner. I will keep you updated on how my love for it grows or does not grow, but right now I really like it. I'm also right now gonna sort this out and put some makeup on, because I need to film a video this morning before I go out. So that is what I'm gonna do right now. Also, while I'm here, I have finished season one of The Missing and I've started season two, so I'm nearly up to date. I got really annoyed last night on Twitter. I don't know if you follow me on Twitter.
because there was someone on there who was tweeting, like, giving things away from yesterday's episode, and I was like, stop it. There are people that haven't watched these things yet and you're ruining them. I just don't understand how people feel the need to like tweet giveaways to things. Like, it's not hard to tweet about something and not give it away, and not give away what's just happened or who someone is, that sort of thing. Stop it, people, because you ruin it for people that aren't up to date yet. Rant over. I am now gonna sort this out. So I just filmed all of this and then proceeded to delete what I just filmed, because I decided to clear out my memory card a little bit and just deleted what I just filmed. Basically, what I was saying is, I did a Twitter poll because I'm going away this weekend. I can't upload this weekend, so it either needs to go up early or late. So I did a Twitter poll, or I'm doing a Twitter poll right now, to say whether you want me to miss Saturday and upload on time, or film Saturday and upload late so it would go up Monday. So far, Miss Saturday is winning by like one vote, I would say. So it looks like it's going to be uploaded on time, but it's missing Saturday, which is fine. I can always add Saturday onto next week's vlog, actually. Yeah, because then what I could do, not film on the Friday, because I go back to work on the Friday, so then I could just not film on the Friday, so you have the extra day. That is a good idea. I might do that. Well, it depends which one wins, but I think upload on time is probably going to win and miss Saturday. So that's probably what's going to happen. I have just filmed a giveaway. I'm very excited. Make sure you check out video at 6 p.m. because it is going to be said giveaway. Yeah, I said I was going to do a giveaway when I hit 1,000 subscribers, so that is what this is. And I'm really excited. I've never done a giveaway on my YouTube channel before. I did one on my blog years ago, when I used to upload regularly on my blog, which I obviously do not now. I'm really tempted to just kind of delete my blog and just completely focus on YouTube, because I don't, to be fair, I don't upload on it anyway. Like, I don't update my blog. I don't really like it. It's not really very me anymore. So I don't know, I might just delete it and just completely focus on, not that I wasn't already, but have like, just have my YouTube channel. So I might do that. But yeah, I did a giveaway on there a few years ago and it was quite successful. So I feel like this one is gonna be exciting. Like, I'm excited for the prizes. I want them, but I can't enter because it's my giveaway. But right now I need to get dressed because I'm still in my pajama bottoms. Not pajama top, but pajama bottoms. Eat some lunch, and then I'm going to Primark because there's a list of things that I want from there. Hopefully there will be everything there that I want, but my Primark is pretty crap, to be honest, and either sells out super quickly and doesn't restock, or just never gets it in the first place. But we will see. There's some really pretty burgundy boots that I think I want to get. They're really, really nice. I'm kind of obsessed with burgundy at the moment, if you can't tell. This is the Charlotte Tilbury lipstick, by the way. Love Liberty. Really like it. Really like it. But yeah, I better go get dressed, sort myself out, so I can go. Because it is actually 1:15 now, and it's going to take probably half an hour, if not maybe a little bit longer, to get into town and park and stuff. So yeah, I'll speak to you later. Bye. I'm ready to go. I feel like I've literally worn this jumper every day since I got it. It's so comfy. I think I'm gonna go into H&M as well, because there's one really close to my Primark, and see if I can get it in some other colours. I just really like it. I've also bunged my hair up because it was annoying me, just because it needs cutting really bad, so it just bugs me at the moment. So it's gone up, and yeah, time to go shopping.
See you from the all, but I want more.
I've just got home. It's like 5:30, but it looks like it's like 11:30 at night. How amazing were those singers? Absolutely incredible. I have found most of, I think, the social media links for the main guy. His voice, literally, I could listen to him sing forever. Oh my goodness, it was amazing. So I'm going to link all of his social medias down below. I don't know how active he is at all, but yeah, he's amazing. So if you're in the Cambridge area, you can see what he's up to and check him out. I think from the looks of things, they're based in Norwich, but I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, so good. Oh my goodness, literally. We stood there for ages just listening to them. Loved their voices together as well. Literally, I could just sit here and praise them all day. But yeah, I found a lot of their social media, so I'm gonna link. I think his name was Felix Simpson, so I've found his and I've linked him down below. I feel like a bit of a stalker, but oh well. Yeah, but anyway, also had a proper lipstick test today. I have had a cup of tea, I've had hot chocolate, and I've eaten a hot cheese melt toasty, and we're still going strong. Love it. I think we have done a good test on the lipstick today, so I'm quite impressed. But right now I am going to edit Sunday night's video, so my little giveaway, I need to edit that, and then I'm going to start editing the vlog, I think, because I go away tomorrow and we're leaving at about 1/2-ish, so I'm not really going to be able to film much tomorrow morning. So I thought if I get most of it done tonight, and then I can add in tomorrow morning whatever I've done and upload it, so it's all ready for Sunday. Because I think, although I haven't checked the poll, hold up, let me check. Oh, hot chocolate's making me burp. Everyone's, oh my goodness, now it's 50-50. Right, let's retweet it. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to miss, so I upload on time, because I don't really like uploading late, but we'll see how it goes. Also, picked up pretty much everything I wanted to pick up in Primark, maybe a few extras. So I think I'm going to do a little Primark haul. It won't be very long, but I prefer quite short hauls, and which you'll know if you've watched my channel for a little while. So yeah, but yeah, go and check out Felix. I tried to find him on Twitter. I don't think he has. I'm such a stalker. I don't think he has a Twitter. I wasn't able to find him. So yeah, he needs to get a Twitter, really. But yeah, I will probably talk to you later. Vlog is all edited and up to date, and giveaway is uploaded. And I've just checked the poll, and you're saying that you don't want me to miss Saturday, you want me to upload late, but I've just edited up to today, so Thursday, and it's already at 33 minutes long. So I think I'm actually just going to end the vlog here, because tomorrow I'm just going to be driving most of the day, so it's not going to be anything to show tomorrow. And Saturday I may add on to next week, I may not. It all depends what I do with my family. So I am going to end the vlog here. So I really hope you enjoyed it. Give the video a thumbs up if you have. Just because I don't want it to be really long. So yeah, I think that it's currently 33 minutes, and that's before this clip. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed the vlog. Give the video a thumbs up if you did. Oh look, who's come to say hi. Hey baby.
Hi. Come on in. Come on. Up you come.
Good girl. The question of the week this week is, do you have a pet? If you have a pet, what is its name? What is it and what is its name? Because I love animals, so I would really like to know that. Yeah. Subscribe if you are new. Also, don't forget to enter the giveaway. Video is going live at 6 p.m. If not, it's already live. Go check it out. And I will see you next week. Goodbye.